The Gold Coast Arts Center recently held its fifth annual Your Big Break competition, which features some of Long Island and Greater New York's best young artists and musicians. And with us today is the Executive Director of the Arts Center, Regina Gill, and this year's competition winner, Paris Ray.
T-shirt to bed, even though it's losing your scent, still reminds me of New York City. Fell asleep on you on the way home, and you let me, even though we weren't looking for anything. It's funny how just be another boy that I knew, 'cause I was so wrong. First time I played you our song, you said, so what's the catch? Where's the fine print? 'Cause from where I stand, you look pretty perfect. You called me trouble, I called you wonderful. It's funny how
Thank you so much.
Everybody's just been listening to Paris Ray. Paris Ray is a 21-year-old indie singer, songwriter, recording artist, and accomplished actress and voiceover artist. That's a lot to do in 21 years.
It's true. I always forget that it's kind of an impressive resume until it's like listed out like that. I'm like, wow, I've done a lot.
You have done a lot, and you have a unique voice.
Thank you so much.
And very original, and your soulful lyrics have gotten you some amazing reviews. And let me see, you've performed live at Center Stage in Cape Cod. You've been on Fox 5 New York Star of the Day. You've been a two-time finalist for CBS's Grammy Gig of a Lifetime, and that was in 2013 and 2014. What were you, five?
Yeah. It was my freshman and sophomore year of college.
That's when you went to college?
I went to SUNY Purchase in Westchester for studio composition.
Which is a very fine which is a very fine place to learn and to study.
Absolutely.
We were actually, the Gold Coast Art Center was a partner with SUNY Purchase for many years.
That doesn't surprise me at all.
Yeah.
Very similar vibes.
They're very dedicated to nurturing talent. Some really amazing people have come out of SUNY
Absolutely.
Purchase, and now you're going to be one of them.
Oh, thank you.
We're here to talk about the Gold Coast Art Center mm-hmm. and how we've been producing for the last 5 years our own version of, what do we call it? We call it Gold Coast Your Big Break, but it's more like it's on the model of the American Idol.
And, absolutely.
And we don't have the voice yet. We have to get some people to be really nasty and get there and judge, but we haven't gotten to that point. But the truth of the matter is you had some pretty serious competition.
I know. That was actually one of my favorite things about it because, it was very humbling. I've always done, I've been singing for so many years now and writing songs and performing. And you come out of high school like being the singer, or you go into college and like you're in the conservatory, so you're used to being like
successful.
You feel good. And especially in Long Island, there's so much talent that you don't really know about. And then I went there and there were all these girls and some guys, but in the finals it was all girls and they were just incredible. And it was like one of the first times I was like, wow, these are really, really good people. And it was super humbling and awesome because I stayed in touch with all the girls.
Oh, did you?
And yeah, we would love to like do it like a reunion show or something.
But that's a good idea.
Yeah, it was awesome. It's really great to meet people in your age bracket who do a similar thing to you.
Now, this program that we've been doing now has been going on, and it's a Saturday night activity, and it's supposed to be something presented for the public to come in and you go for dinner, that's great. But most people just have those options of just going out for dinner and going home, or going to the movies and going home. And this live performance opportunity, the talent was pretty strong, would you say?
I totally agree, and I thought it was awesome. It was really like a showcase. It was less of a competition, more of like, wow, look at all these talented.
Like a variety show.
Yeah, it was
awesome.
That's
how we saw it.
I loved it.
So you went through the levels, there were tears before you got to the finals.
Tears. Yeah, it was really, really, it was just really cool. I try to look at everything as a showcase, because I don't like being like, oh gosh, like, I don't like comparing myself to others, especially with music, because everyone's so good and it's so individual. So I just go out there and I play like really honest songs, and it's really vulnerable and really personable, and it's always really exciting when people respond to that. So I just try to just do it and it's like throwing spaghetti at the wall and seeing what sticks.
I think it's a little more than throwing spaghetti at the wall, but that's okay. For people out there who don't know what the life of a singer-songwriter is like when you're not Taylor Swift, what is it like to get to the point where you've even got the kinds of successes you've had?
I mean, so much of it has been like the support of my parents and my mom. Because I started acting when I was really young, like when I was like 5 or 6. And I did some TV shows. I was on Conan O'Brien, and then I was on iCarly. Yeah, so that was when
I
was younger.
Wait a second, you were 5 or 6, you were on Conan?
I think I was on Conan when I was like 9. But 5 or 6, I was doing some, I was doing like doll boxes and like modeling and stuff like that. And then I loved it. I loved acting, and my mom was a rock star and would drive me to auditions. I was still in school. I went to public school. I wasn't homeschooled. And then when I got into college, I was like, okay, I think I really love music, because I'd always done it, but then I really like delved into it and made it, I don't know, there's something about, with acting, there's so much rejection and, like needing to fit other people's mold of like what a character is, and I totally get that. But it's hard, because I am a very passionate person, I get invested in all these roles. So to be told like, oh, like you're too short, or like, oh, your hair's not light enough, I'm like, I can't do this. So with music, I just write about my life, and the response I've gotten is incredible. And it's so rewarding that people can relate to really personal things that I've gone through. So I just really, really fell in love with it. And now I play shows at like restaurants and bars, and I just go in and I walk in and I have my guitar. I'm like, hi, I'm Paris. I sing songs. Do you want me to play here? For the most part, they always let me, which is cool. I try to hit as many open mics as possible because that's how I get other performances from people.
And where are these things listed? So in other words, if there's some 17-year-old out there.
Yes.
And that person is saying, I would love to be where you are when I'm 21.
So I would say, honestly, the biggest thing is like, if you want to be a writer, just write. And like the first 5 songs you're going to write, you're going to hate. But that doesn't matter because other people will like them. And you just have to keep going and force yourself to write something every day. And then there's all open mics all over Long Island. I think the website would be like Long Island Open Mic, and they have some. There's like one. There's a bunch in Port Jeff. There's a bunch. I'm from St. James, so there's one in St. James. But it's just really important to play and like get performance opportunities, so you get more comfortable. Like, because now my banter is pretty good. Like, I know how to like talk to people from performing. I wasn't always good at that, and that's something that sets me apart.
That's hard.
It's hard.
So we always say there's the talent. And then there's actual performance skills.
Right.
And those are two different things.
Absolutely.
And then we get to the business part of it, but I'm not going to talk about that with you. But the performance skills, who are the people who told you, now you don't bow, or you do bow, or you say hi, or you wave, or if you get a heckler, this is how you deal.
Right.
Or if somebody's drunk in the audience, what do you say?
I think it's pretty funny, because I think something that sets me apart is that I don't do the traditional, I don't respond how most people respond. I have a pretty,
what does that mean?
I'm trying to explain, like, I don't know, like, I'm very, very, like, quirky when I'm performing, and, like, I talk exactly how I'm talking, like, at a show, and I think people find it endearing, because my songs are, like, kind of beautiful, and, like,
and personal.
Yeah, and then I'm like, hey, guys, like, how's it going? And they're like, what is up with that girl? But it's, like, quirky, I guess, and it's the only way I can do it. So I don't really, no one really told me what to do. I was nervous if, like, the way I acted at shows was, I don't know, cool. And then people were like, you know, people are responding well, so just be yourself. So I guess that's what it is. It's just be yourself and be authentic. Don't try to fit what you're supposed to do as a performer or, like, anything like that, because it comes off as very, like, rehearsed.
I'm going to return to what you said, because some people think, well, talent, that's it. Talent is enough. Talent is not enough. That's why people go to school. That's why people practice.
Absolutely.
That's why that joke about how do you get to Carnegie Hall came into being. And the truth is, even if you're a painter or a visual artist, somebody or a writer, that if you spend 15 minutes, somebody said you dedicate 1 hour, but if you can't do an hour, make it 15 minutes a day, shut off your phone, shut off your life, don't let anybody disturb you, and just write, even if it's just in a journal.
Absolutely, that's what I do. I journal every single day.
You do, that's
great. I have a journal for journaling, and then a whole journal for like lyric ideas and like pretty images that come to mind and stuff. And I know that sounds kind of cheesy, but they told me to do it in college, and like my writing is just
the best
like,
thing you could probably, I highly recommend
it. It's amazing.
And if you're an artist, doodle.
Absolutely.
It's enough.
Just have to keep creating. Yeah.
And just because you get in touch here and here.
Yeah.
That's great. That's fantastic. Yeah. So let's talk about this opportunity, some of the opportunities that you've gotten. I happen to have a list here of in winning the 2017 Your Big Break, and Paris Ray won the 2017 Your Big Break, and she got, as a result, the chance to open for national acts at major venues like the Paramount, which we'll come back to. She's got recording time at D-City Studios and online TV streaming opportunities on Indie Music TV, a feature on Reverb Nation, musical equipment from Zoom North America. Mm-hmm. Oh, we'll talk about that. A $250 credit with AllMusic and a song deal with Betamax and PR and social media campaign and a whole bunch of services from the Rick Eberle Agency and more and more and more.
So we did blown away by you. I am so blown away, and I'm so incredibly grateful, because I just like playing. So the fact that I got all these incredible opportunities, like, I mean, it really does feel like a Your Big Break, because it feels like all these really cool things are going to happen, and I have such a good feeling that, I've been talking to Dave about recording some of my songs. He was one of the judges, and he was, like, really excited about my songs.
See your mentor?
He wasn't my mentor.
Or your mentor was John Hampson?
Yeah, he was super great, super helpful, but Dave was one of the judges, and it was really nice, because he's like a tough guy. He's like, he doesn't look like someone who would get my music. And he was like, Paris, we're going to do such amazing things. So I was like, oh my gosh, Dave. So I'm excited that he's excited. And then once that's recorded, then Rick's going to promote it, and they're going to do it's going to all come at once. And I'm hoping I just take it by storm.
So it's a new platform. So you're here, and now you get to hear.
That's how I really feel, right? Yeah, absolutely.
Well, you're young, and you certainly have the gift, and
you have the
drive, and
I feel it just sitting next to you.
Talk to me about the Paramount.
I love the Paramount. I played in a lot of really cool places, like in high school and stuff, like some places in the city, like the National Underground and the Bitter End, which are like renowned places, and that's super cool.
I have news for you. The Bitter End was a place that I hung out in when I was in
really?
High school. Just so
it's
you know.
It's a cool place.
It's been around a little bit.
But there's something about like the Paramount, because as you know, I'm 21, so when I was in high school, that's where I would go to see like the bands that I love. Oh my gosh, so the fact that I'm gonna be there and I'm gonna get to open, and it's cool because they're gonna look for someone who's a good match for me that I can open, and then that's, I mean, how cool
would
it be?
What would that mean? Well, how would,
so
if you had to pick a match for you
so
out of everybody in the universe, who would
I would
you pick?
Pick Ingrid Michaelson.
Oh, okay.
Hands down, and like I know she plays with Paramount sometimes, so I don't know, but.
Fingers crossed.
You know, I just want someone where people are gonna go for really good lyrics, for not like a big performance-y show, but for like a really intimate, you know, like evening kind of a thing, because then anyone who's going for that is gonna love me, and then hopefully my fan base grows, you know, that many people.
Okay, so what we would like to do before we close here,
okay.
We're not gonna ask you to sing the national anthem as you did in 2013 for a Mets-Dodgers game at Citi Field. How cool is that?
That's the coolest thing.
But we are gonna ask you to finish this segment
awesome.
For us with another song.
Okay, this song
Paris
is called,
Ray.
Thank you. This is Astronomy. This is, I think, the song that won the competition for me, so.
Say that again.
This is the song that I think won the competition for me. Sorry, I was very mumbly. Okay.
I became a doctor so that I could stitch you up. So did my heart beating, but it wasn't enough. So I became a superhero, tried to save your life, but you took my cape away from me. So that I could make you tall. Soon you were just made of stone. I was singing to a wall. So I turned into ivy. Thought maybe I'd grow on you. My leaves weren't pretty. So you dug up my roots. Now I became an astronaut so I could give you space. Thought maybe you'd love me if I went away. Thought you'd look through your telescope and finally see me as a star. But I am just happy to be an astronomer. And I became your shadow. Stretched out on the grass, the only time you wanted me was when it was overcast. So I turned into sunshine, but by then you want tonight. I think no matter what I was to you, I would have been too bright. And I became an astronaut so I could give you space. Thought maybe you'd love me.
Not surprised. Well, thank you all. We are delighted to have been able to speak to Paris Ray, and we look forward to watching your career grow.
Oh, thank you so much.